Dear students, in this class we explain why stationarity is important in econometrics. The issue of non-stationarity is encountered whenever we deal with the time series data. So in order to understand the importance of stationarity, let us remember this. The issue was not recognized till 1980s. Since the publication of the paper by Nelson and Plosser, Angel and Granger, etc., applied economists or applied econometricians using time series data became aware of some of the difficulties associated with using time series in econometric analysis, especially when unit roots are present in the data. Unit roots is another name of non-stationarity, and we will consider this issue in detail in a later class. So applied econometricians using time series data became aware of the difficulties in estimating econometric models when the time series data is characterized by unit roots. To ignore the problem of unit roots, non-stationarity means you will get what is known as nonsensical, spurious results. Spurious results, nonsensical results. An issue first introduced in statistics in 1926 by Yule. This example also we will consider in the next session. If you ignore the issue of non-stationarity when you use time series, you will get spurious results, spurious regression, for example, nonsensical results. And as we have discussed in the last class, detrending is not appropriate. And if you difference the data to remove non-stationarity, as I told you, if the trend is deterministic, detrending is enough. But if a trend is non-stochastic, the solution is differencing. But differencing is only part of the answer. The problem is, if you use differenced data to overcome the problems created by non-stationarity, you will remove any long-run relationship between variables, because it is said that a relation between stationary variables is a short-run relation. So differencing will solve the problem, but when you difference the data, you will lose, you will get rid of any long-run information. So, when we model time series data, we need to retain the long-run information, because economic theory is more informative about long-run relation. But at the same time, ensure that a significant relation is not the result of stochastic trends. Stochastic trends, common trends. So what is required is differencing is a solution to the problem of non-stationarity, but it is only a part of the problem because differencing will eliminate long-run equilibrium relationship between economic variables, and it is in the case of long-run equilibrium relationship between variables and its estimation is more important in economics, or economic theory is more informative about long-run relation. So if you use differenced data, this long-run relation is lost. So to deal with these issues, we have to consider issues like co-integration and similar topics. Before going into such details, let us see what are the problems associated with non-stationarity, or why stationarity is important. The first one is, as we have discussed earlier, the behavior of the time series is considerably different whether the process is stationary or not. If a time series is stationary, and if there is a shock to the series, the effect of the shock is short-lived. It has no permanent memory. It forgets what happens in a few time periods. So it has only a short memory. The effect of a shock is transitory, so that the series will return to the underlying trends in a quick span of time. On the other hand, if a time series is non-stationary, shock has permanent effects. The effect of a shock is integrated into the series, so the name integrated series. So it has long memory. For a stationary series, the memory is very short. The difference we have considered earlier, remember this, in the case of a random walk model, yt is equal to epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 plus etc. epsilon t. It is a cumulative sum of all the previous shocks. In the case of a stationary series, yt is equal to phi 1 square plus epsilon t plus phi 1 cube plus cube epsilon t minus 1 plus etc. etc. The effect of a shock die out over time. So the nature of the time series is different. The effect of a shock is different whether the series is stationary or not. The second is, if you use non-stationary variables for econometric analysis, the possibility of getting spurious regression, non-sensical regression is very high. That means if two time series are non-stationary, you will get a significant relationship between variables, even though the variables are not related. But spurious regression is possible in cross-section data. Spurious regression is also possible with I0 variables, I1 variables without a trend. These are some issues which we will consider in the next class. Anyway, the issue is, even if two variables are not showing any tendency to increase or decrease together, they wander, as in the case of pure random walk, there is a possibility that you will get a significant relationship between two. So the point is, if you regress yt on xt, and if they are non-stationary, t of the slope coefficient will be significant. And also, you will get a high R square value. These are symptoms of spurious regression. That is the second consequence of using non-stationary variables. A third one is, if a time series are non-stationary, the standard assumptions used for hypothesis testing is not valid. That is, the hypothesis testing procedure is not valid. The point is, T will not follow standard T distribution. And F for testing the overall significance will not follow standard F distribution. So, the conventional hypothesis testing procedure using the nominal level of significance is invalid because the distribution of T will be different. Distribution of F will also be different. They are non-standard. So you cannot take a decision about the significance, or you cannot take a decision about whether to accept or reject a hypothesis on the basis of critical T values or critical F values. So these are the issues associated with using non-stationary variables. One is, the behavior is different. Second is, the possibility of getting spurious regression, nonsensical regression, is very high. The third is, the standard hypothesis testing procedures using T, F, etc. are invalid. So the point is, if a series is non-stationary, it cannot be used directly in estimation. Well, one must be careful about using such variables in regression analysis. When I say non-stationarity, what I mean is difference stationary, not trend stationary. If you plot the data and if you observe an upward trend, and if the trend is deterministic, you can still use the variables by giving trend as an additional variable in the model. But the general belief is that most of the time series in econometrics is difference stationary rather than trend stationary. So the problem of non-stationarity is very important. Before using the variables, time series variables in regression analysis, we must first consider whether the variables are stationary or not. So the first thing is, you plot the data. Observe whether the variables exhibits a trend-like behavior or not. Then we use the formal tests for non-stationarity. Then only we can use them for regression analysis, hypothesis testing, etc., etc.